Sanitation and hygiene remain a major challenge in Kampala City, with many institutions lacking basic sanitation facilities such as toilets. Dozens of schools are faced with inadequate toilet stances, and others are stuck with filled-up toilets. This has put the lives of the learners and teachers at risk of contracting diseases. According to some school head teachers, besides having inadequate toilet facilities to cater for the big number of learners and teachers, access to clean water remains a big challenge in many city schools. The head teachers of these schools are asking the government to design a special water tariff for the schools in order to reduce the high cost of water bills.
This is the high water bills. And you know how much children love water. When they open a tap, they want to use it in the way they feel, satisfying their need. They play with it, they wash, yes, they enjoy washing and playing at the same time. Therefore, water, the consumption of water is normally very high at school. And the bills are also what? Commensurately high.
Leaders in the Nakawa division have now come out to offer free cesspool emptying services. They hope this will enable the schools to improve on their sanitation.
On the other hand, we are supplementing the efforts of city to make Nakawa a better place in many ways. But one of them is that we have added on our fleet some new garbage trucks, and we are going to improve on the garbage collection in Nakawa. We believe this will also improve on our hygiene and sanitation campaign.
Most of our schools are not connected to the national sewer network, and therefore they have an on-site sanitation facility which is susceptible to filling up. And when they fill up, schools don't have resources to empty them. The executive director, Dorothy Kisaka, with management, procured two garbage trucks, one emptying trucks, to purposely manage the sanitation and solid waste situation.
Mugambe has also noted that landlords of residential houses without toilets will be arrested and prosecuted. This was during a water sanitation and hygiene wash dialogue between teachers, local leaders, and City Uganda.
We have a challenge of landlords who have, you find someone housing over 40 people without a pit latrine or a toilet. We condemn that in the strongest terms, and you are saying on that we shall have no mercy, we shall only prosecute them as per the Public Health Act. We shall not tolerate this. This is a crime. This is murder.
The city tries to provide space because we know we cannot do so much, and we cannot do so much if we come together. So the space that we have today is aimed at for us to highlight what is going on in terms of information, like the information that we have received from the TC, and then the challenges that we have within our communities, the challenges that we have within our schools, and for that matter, we also want to elicit solutions. So the expectation is that for us, by the end of the day today, after we hear from the communities, after we hear from the schools around the wash situation, we should be able to sit as a team that is here today to see what is it that we can do.
This story has been filed by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.